This, a two-way jump-off-now competition going on for the gold medal, and we're going to go back to Santa Anita Park for that equestrian show jumping event in just a moment. But let me tell you that so far these games have basically been uneventful, but we have had an accident this afternoon. Down on the Harbor Freeway, a helicopter crashed, which is right next to, and the crash site was right next to the L.A. Coliseum at the Exposition Boulevard turnoff. Three people were on board. Two only had minor injuries, and luckily no cars, no other people in that area were hit at the time. Now, this site is near the L.A. Coliseum, which is the location for tonight's closing ceremonies. And as you can see, traffic is starting to build up in that area. The helicopter was that of a California Highway Patrol carrying three men on board. As I said before, only two had minor injuries. And really, if you look at how the possibilities for tragedy in this event, if it came possibly maybe 2 hours later, there you see the helicopter. I think that's the south side or Harbor Freeway, right next to Exposition Boulevard turnoff. So you see that the possibilities for some tragedy was completely abated. So now we have a group of men with us in our studio, which are very happy and wearing a lot of gold. Here's Frankie.
Indeed they are, Kathleen. You know, it was the first time in Olympic history that the U.S. took home a medal in men's volleyball, and that medal was a gold one. Two games up and ahead of Brazil in the third and final game, 13-6. Let's take a look at the end of that game, the happy end of many years of hard work.
Right on top of Brazil, they haven't really let them in the game. They haven't let Brazil get high emotionally like they usually do. Ball is out. Match point, USA, serving for the gold medal in volleyball. Hit off the block. Quiets the crowd down quickly here.
Bobby, how do you impress with the play of this USA team tonight? They're handling Brazil very easily.
Leading 14-6. Brazil serving. Another jump serve. There's an effective one. That's the serve that has given the United States so much trouble. Let's take another look at that.
This is only their second ace of the night. They had 11 on the last time these two teams played. That's the big difference.
Let's keep in mind that this is the U.S. team that is for real. They beat the Soviet Union four times in a row in the Soviet Union in May.
But they have to be considered the top team in the world until they play the Soviets, and the Soviets prove otherwise.
DeWillius coming in, replacing Pat Powers in the back line to serve. Serving for the match. United States 14, Brazil 7 for the gold medal. Wiping some perspiration off the floor. Mark Waldy in the United States serving from the back line. For the gold medal.
U.S. coach has done a great job of preparing this U.S. team after a devastating defeat 3 days ago.
Rausman setting to Silva in the corner. Good play by Brazil. Brazil needs a run now to get back in this match. Down 15-6, 15-6, and 14-7 in the third. Mario Shundel, the player they go to for their big hits when they're in trouble. And he serves into the net. That's the 15th serving mistake by Brazil.
The best serving team
in the world. Match point again. Steve Timmons served for the United States. De Silva, to Rausman.
Joining me now are two very happy and deserving medal winners, Karch Kei and Dusty Dvorak, and of course the head coach, Doug Beal, who doesn't get a gold medal but a lot of satisfaction. Dusty, let me start with you. First of all, they blew you away on Monday night. You turn around and blew them away. I mean, the whole thing is kind of mind-blowing. Is there any one significant thing you can say that turned this whole thing around?
Well, I think last night we were playing for the gold, and you know, we came out and played our game, and you know, we weren't settling for anything less than a gold medal.
Could you feel an emotional difference from the last Monday night?
Definitely. When we played them Monday night, it didn't really matter if we won or lost. We were still in the semis. They had a must-win situation to make the medal round, and we were definitely much more intense and ready to play last night.
Garcha, Tom Selleck, the honorary captain, was justifiably proud, I guess, but he almost popped his PI last night when he kept pointing out that didn't matter about the boycott because you guys have defeated the Soviets in the spring, I think, four straight games. Did this make this a little sweeter for you?
We're lucky to be together year-round like this because we get the chance to tour with a lot of those teams. Unlike the basketball team, they really didn't get to play some of the other teams, although they are obviously the best team in the world too. But we're lucky in that we get to tour around, and we proved that we beat Russia four straight. We've beaten Bulgaria about eight straight now. We've beaten Poland 11 out of 13, and we beat Cuba six times. This was all in the last year, and those were the four teams that
And you're wearing the gold medal. And I know all of you realize one thing. Doug, we have to go back to the show jumping and the equestrian, but I want to ask you, you have to feel good about what this is going to do for volleyball as a sport around the world, literally.
Yeah, I think, you know, everything's just worked out perfectly for us here at the Games. We got great coverage. The team played well. We accomplished everything we wanted when we set the program up. You know, it's a great group of guys, and you know, I couldn't be happier for everybody involved in the program.
Couldn't be happier for you. Okay, thank you, gentlemen, for being with us.